So in this video, we start off as usual with a galaxy inside a bottle. And we start off also with a burning desire to clean up the Comfy UI user interface, to clean up all the noodles and to get it looking nice and smart. We're going to be looking at how to do that using an amazing plugin that will clean things up amazingly and give us superpowers beyond your imagination. Well, maybe not beyond your imagination if you've used Automatic 1111, because we're going to be bringing some of the functionality that we see inside of Automatic 1111 inside of this user interface. At least that's going to be the case for those guys in the YouTube membership. I'm going to be loading up a longer version of this video to the YouTube membership. For those guys who want the full shebang, all the details, you can head on over to the course and you can get a discount code in the description that will allow you to sign up for the course. It's well over 4 hours of quality material on Comfy UI, SDXL, and Stable Diffusion. And that will give you all the details. But here we're just gonna cover the basics and it's gonna be amazing. So we start off with the user interface here. And we want to basically recreate this, but without the soup, without the noodle soup going on. So we go ahead and clear everything, okay? And we need to install a plugin. And to do that, we're going to be going to Efficiency Nodes Comfy UI on GitHub. That's the one we're going to be using. And you can see a sample here of what this particular genius has created with the anime going on there, and there are various workflows that there are inside of this project that you can take a look at. Now there's a direct download link if you want to just download that. I think you can just you can extract that with a zip 7-zip maybe inside of the custom nodes directory in Comfy UI. Now I've already done that, and you need to restart Comfy in order to get everything showing up. There are some installation instructions down here if you need more assistance. Let's go to Comfy and let's start this thing up. So we'll start off by going to Add Node and Efficiency Nodes. So you should see this menu once it's installed. We're going to go to Loaders. We're going to choose Efficient Loader. And we can then start choosing our tensor file. I think we can zoom in a little bit like that. Let's go for the one with the baked VAE. So DreamShaper 6 baked VAE. We've got a clip skip option. So I spoke about Automatic 1111 and the features that you find there. And maybe you can see now what I was talking about. We can also load up a LoRa stack and different LoRAs and their strengths. We're just going to focus on keeping it nice and simple. Let's go ahead and we'll go with 512 by 512. For our batch, we'll keep it size 1. We can do fancy stuff that doesn't necessarily involve the batch size. We'll choose another efficiency node. This one is going to be the sampler, and there are two. We're going to choose the first one, the efficient K sampler. Now watch carefully. How difficult was that? So you can see how easy this is. Now, should we be able at this stage to produce an image? I think we should, but let's not just create some galaxy in a bottle that we're going to get rid of anyway. Let's just go ahead and create a preview. So down here, we've got preview image enabled. Shall we try to run this and see if it will actually run? Well, you can see it's reading and it's running. So for once, we haven't got a galaxy in a bottle. We've got positive. Who knows what that's reading right there. So with the power of editing, I went ahead and copied the text from the previous render and changed the CKPT name and the VAE name for the for this particular render so that it was the same as the previous one that we did, and also put in the same seed number. And I think we've got an identical looking render there. So it's looking nice. And it's also looking neat. Now, this ability to preview here is one of the main features that you have with the efficiency nodes for Comfy UI. It makes life a lot easier. But Kevin, I hear you saying, we haven't got an output image. We've just got a preview image. So let's zoom out and let's go ahead and I think we need to see an image, don't you? So we'll come here, we'll click and drag and we can choose save image. And you know what? I'm actually going to copy this because I want to see if I can get this again. Let's change the CFG to 8, Q prompt. And we've now actually got a saved image. So we've now got the preview image and the saved image. So this is how you can make Comfy UI. You can actually disable this if you want to, if you've got the save image there. So this is how you can make Comfy UI a lot more neat. Think about how much easier it is to actually get this looking the way it is, and how we've got so few noodles here. I don't know if it's possible to actually combine the save image so that we don't have to repeat this like that. It may be possible. There's an option we can sort of shift click and then right click and choose nest selected nodes. That might work, it might not work, I haven't tried it. But that's basically how we can clean up the user interface. Now, like I say, guys, I'll have this software is capable of a lot more than this, and I'll have a longer video in the membership for the channel and an even longer video for the course if you want to sign up for that. But that's going to be it for this one. Do give this a try. It's a really, really nice one.